Welcome to Lair the Alchemist, where we discuss all things heavy metal and hard rock. On today's episode, five more awesome album covers. I did a video not too long ago with five awesome album covers. People seem to really like it. There's so many cool album covers out there. I needed to do a couple more episodes, so I picked five more cool, awesome album covers. All right, kind of touching on some different bands, some bands I didn't cover in the last video. So here we go with number one. Now this is definitely a really iconic album cover in rock and roll. The Beatles, Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band. You've got all these different famous people on the cover here. This was done by Peter Blake and Jan Hayworth using cardboard cutouts and wax figures, of course, not of the band. They painted a bass drum. They laid all this stuff out here on the front, and they wanted it to look like Sgt. Pepper's Lonely Hearts Club Band here hanging around after a concert with their fans. And you can go on Wikipedia and you can see the breakdown of everybody who's in here. These are, like I said, there's cardboard cutouts in here, and there's also wax figures inside here. That was something I did not know until I started researching this. You've got like a little doll guy there. So just a small few of the 57 photographs and 9 waxworks in here. You have Bob Dylan, Marlon Brando's in here, Stockhausen, Karlheinz Stockhausen, who is a 20th century German composer, Einstein, Freud, Aleister Crowley, has a real, this shows for me the Beatles kind of moving into their more psychedelic era. The band is clearly left behind, sort of the mop top era. There are sporting mustaches here. They've got on these bright costumes. You see the guys on the inside here. You know, this is them moving into the more experimental phase of the band. I would say they started moving in this direction on Rubber Soul and Revolver, but this you could easily make an argument is the best Beatles album, maybe one of the greatest albums of all time. And the cover is just iconic. You can sit here and have fun staring at this and looking at all these different people and cultural people and wondering why they're in there. some of these people. So it's really interesting. It's one of these, you know, stuff like this gets lost on a CD booklet, certainly on a cassette. So this is definitely something that was made for an album cover, and just really fun to stare at this. And it's got the lyrics and everything on the back. So just awesome. Sgt. Pepper's, and the band had a say, and they were able to put out who they wanted in the audience there. Some of their things got shot down. They wanted Jesus and Gandhi, and some of those things got shot down by the record label. Apparently Ringo Starr was just, I don't care, you know, let the other guys decide who they want to pick in there. But and you know, for this time, this was one of the more involved album covers for its era, and it's something that would go on to be so influential that it sort of upped everybody's game with album covers. Frank Zappa did a spoof on this with his "We're Only in It for the Money." I think the Rolling Stones, you know, tried to get into this sort of psychedelic thing too at one phase. So just an awesome, amazing album cover. All right, next, maybe one of the most famous artists in the genre of 80s heavy metal. I'm talking about Derek Riggs. This is Iron Maiden's Killers. I could have picked, gosh, any Iron Maiden album cover, and Derek Riggs was very involved in Iron Maiden, all their album covers, all their 12-inch singles, and just everything involving Eddie, and he was the guy that invented Eddie. And I went with Killers because I think on the first Iron Maiden album, if you notice Eddie on here, he's sort of evolved a little bit. He's sort of fleshed out a little bit more, if you want to say that about a sort of zombie guy here. But he's seems to be made out a little bit more and a little more detail added to him. And this is a great cover. You got him with the bloody axe. Whose hands are those down there clutching on the city in the background here? Apparently this was like some apartments or, you know, out the window from Derek Riggs when he was making this streetlight. And Derek Riggs covers are always full of little things here. The windows open a little bit right there. You can see some shop names back here. So his art was always great, not only for the main image, but you could also just sit here and pick out all these little details. And he would really take that to another level with albums like Somewhere in Time, where there's all kinds of little hidden messages and stuff like that. Great live shot on the back, Deano Air. I love this old school square pictures of the band there, but could have picked a lot of Derek Riggs things, and maybe other Iron Maiden covers are going to show up later, but for me, this is one of my favorites of the early Iron Maiden, Derek Riggs. All right, next, another one of the big legendary metal bands, Judas Priest's Sad Wings of Destiny. Maybe up there with British Steel as my favorite Judas Priest album cover. This was done by fantasy artist Patrick Woodruff, and the title of the piece was Fallen Angels. And this is just great. I mean, the title, Sad Wings of Destiny, and this picture just absolutely awesome and epic. You sort of got the skulls in the skull in the background there, and like flames and stuff. The Judas Priest logo at the top looks great. And you can't really, it's probably hard to see in here, but the Judas Priest cross thing is hanging on a necklace from a necklace here. That Judas Priest symbol shows up for the first time on here. So this is just awesome. One of my favorite heavy metal albums of all time. I've got a soft spot in my heart for pictures of angels, and that's kind of sort of the symbolism in that. And Priest, this is something that they would sort of carry with them. Like when they did, I did a video on Angel of Retribution, and I talked about the references back to this album and back to the cover of the album with angels and angel wings and stuff. There's the back cover, more live shots of the band. Great shot there of Rob. So this is a great example of an album that's a cover that sets the mood for me. For this record, this record, one of my top five probably Priest albums, it just has a great feel and atmosphere to the album, and this album cover just plays into that perfectly, giving it its epic, epic feel to it. Whereas their, like for instance, their first album cover, Rockarola, with the bottle cap on it, you know, this to me just screams heavy metal. It's a great, great early heavy metal album cover and legendary. Judas Priest, Sad Wings of Destiny. Patrick Woodworth, some interesting trivia here, also did the Budgie album cover for Bandolier, which is like the budgies on the horses. And he did Stradivarius's Fright Night. All right, next. How about Queen's News of the World? This one's interesting because I don't know if I'm going to be able to get all this in here. It sort of album opens up to the whole thing here. And I've always loved this album cover. It was done by sci-fi artist Frank Kelly Frias, who's been inducted into the Science Fiction Hall of Fame. It was inspired by a cover of an magazine called Outstanding Science Fiction. Astounding Science Fiction. I said that wrong. Not outstanding. Astounding Science Fiction. I can say it. I can. Apparently one of the guys in the band, I think it was Roger Taylor, saw this cover. They got in touch with the artist and said, hey, can you do something like this? And it was a very similar cover, a robot, and he had a dying man in his hands. And he said, can you do something similar to that, but can you do the band members? So that's where they came up with this. And you've got sort of Roger, and I believe that's the bass player, John, falling from his hands, and Brian and Freddie, I think, in there. Little bit of blood on his hands. And what I love about this cover is this sort of the robot, the look on his face is sort of like this innocent, childlike, doesn't know that he's killing everybody. And the inside, he's reaching inside, I don't know what it is, a stadium or something, pulling people out. Queen, always a big, epic band with the vocal harmonies in the arrangements. So for me, this is a great, great cover that fits the epicness of Queen. Yeah, very cool sci-fi-ish type cover for Queen. So over here. All right, and for my last one, this one popped up in a lot of people's lists. So of course I had to put it on here. Blue Oyster Cult, Fire of Unknown Origin. What an awesome album cover. Talk about an album cover that really puts you in the mood for the record and the band. Blue Oyster Cult has always had kind of a sci-fi-ish vibe to what they do. And here you go. This is just great. Greg Scott drew this, and he was the art director for Rolling Stone magazine and the New York Times at the time that he did this. And this is just great because it's, again, it captures all the great elements of Blue Oyster Cult, the sci-fi thing, the title, Fire of Unknown Origin. What is this? Is this a cult? Is this the Blue Oyster Cult? They're holding oysters there in their hands. you just got this layers of people. Are they space aliens? What are they? The back cover is also cool. This thing here with the legendary Blue Oyster Cult symbol. So this is another one that really just perfectly captures the mood of this record, Veterans of the Psychic War, that just fits right in for me with this album cover. Sometimes you have an album cover and it just seems like, well, they just picked a cover. And then sometimes you have covers that really just seem like they really fit with the music. And this is one of those covers for me, Blue Oyster Cult's Fire of Unknown Origin. All right, so there you go. Five more cool album covers. It's nothing more fun than putting a record on and just sitting there and staring at the album cover. So I had a lot of great suggestions in the comments for the other video that I did. Leave some more for me. Let me know what you think of these album covers. I'm going to be doing more. This isn't the be-all end-all. You'll probably see more Derek Riggs too. From these similar same bands. So let me know what you think of these in the comments. Give me some other suggestions. Make sure you hit like and subscribe. And until we see you again, make sure you stay heavy, stay metal.